Dr. Curtis, what are the risks and benefits of medication to treat stroke or atrial fibrillation?
Well, the obvious benefit is to prevent the stroke in the first place, or if a patient's already had a stroke, to prevent the next one. And so that's the benefit from it. The risk for these drugs, whether they are aspirin-like drugs, which technically go by the term antiplatelet agents, or anticoagulants or other kinds of blood thinners, they work in different ways to prevent clots, but in both cases, because they're trying to prevent clot, they can actually promote bleeding. And so the biggest risk factor for any of these drugs is the risk of bleeding. However, in patients who are high risk, the risk of stroke is high enough that you get a benefit from giving the drug. So the benefit is that the risk of stroke is reduced so much that, in my opinion, I'm sure yours as well, that far outweighs the risk of bleeding that we have with that, because that's relatively low. And what we really want to do is prevent strokes in patients, whether they're at risk for it because of atrial fibrillation or because of other reasons.
I absolutely agree. The lack of anticoagulation resulting in the stroke is such a detrimental thing to the patient and the family, and for us too, you know. So we need to be very careful in selecting the patient who's appropriate should be anticoagulated. Now, for older patients with a high risk for falls or bleeding, those are a little bit of a tricky situation. What do you think about these things?
Well, that's a common misunderstanding. People think that if you're at risk for falling, that you can't be on anticoagulants. I know there's a study that was done some years back that someone would have to fall at least 200 times to have the risk of taking these blood thinners outweigh the benefits you're going to get from preventing stroke. So that's one common misconception. And another important point I'd like to make is that when patients have strokes related to atrial fibrillation, they tend to be worse. They tend to be more devastating than strokes for other reasons. So patients who have a stroke related to atrial fibrillation are more likely to be bedridden and more likely to require longer-term care than strokes for other reasons. It just emphasizes how important it is to try to prevent them.